This small boat chugging up the Mekong River near Krache, Cambodia, represents one of the last hopes for the critically endangered Mekong Irrawaddy dolphin. The tourists on board are here to catch a glimpse of the shy creatures in their natural habitat. The money they spend on transport, guides, accommodation, and food gives locals an alternative income from fishing, which experts say is one of the keys to the dolphin's survival. Overfishing, particularly with illegal gill nets, is held mainly responsible for decimating the dolphin population. Gill nets are laid across the river and indiscriminately trap everything that swims into them, including dolphins and their calves. Pollution from mining interests in the area, as well as growing concerns about the impact of hydroelectric dams on the river, are other causes of great concern for the future survival of the species. According to the WWF, there are just 80 Irrawaddy dolphins left, living in a short stretch of river from northern Cambodia to southern Laos. Former fisherman Su Sochia says he's packed away his nets and instead earns a better living bringing tourists to see the dolphins living near his village.
ដល់បង្កើតជាសមាគមមានទូកចម្លងខ្ញុំក៏មកចែកទូកជូនភ្ញៀវមើលសត្វផ្សោតហើយតាំងពីមានទូកចែកមើលសត្វផ្សោតមកជីវភាពក៏រីកចម្រើនជាងមុនបន្តិចបាទក្រំថាបើរួចខ្លួនមិនពិបាកមិនបាច់ដើរស៊ីឈ្នួលស្រុកគេស្រុកឯងបាទអញ្ចឹងពួកខ្ញុំក៏ខិតខំជួយអភិរក្សសត្វផ្សោតថែរក្សាសត្វផ្សោត
The engine is cut and oars are used when the boats are near the dolphins, so they are not scared away by the noise. The tourists are deposited onto the riverbank next to the dolphin pools for better viewing. Chum Sita has come dolphin spotting with a tour group from his village in faraway Prey Veng province. Dark blue to grey in color and growing up to 2.5 meters in length, they are recognizable by their small dorsal fins and bulging foreheads. Spotting the elusive creatures is by no means guaranteed. Unlike their saltwater cousins, Irrawaddy dolphins rarely show curiosity towards people, and they never approach the tourist boats. There is no optimum time of day to see them, as their activity patterns don't change much throughout the day. Although there is a better chance of seeing them up close during the dry season when the river level drops. Tola is the manager of the Cambodian Rural Development Team, which works closely with the WWF to protect the dolphins.
There used to be hundreds of dolphins along the Mekong River. During the Pol Pot regime, some of them were killed. Based on the local people told me that the Pol Pot killed them to collect the oil for the generators. And after the Pol Pot regime, some of the dolphins were killed as well because of the illegal fishing. Because in that time, Cambodia is still in the chaos. There was no law which is really working very well.
Dolphin tourism is now one of the biggest industries in this part of Cambodia, employing many people both directly and indirectly. The people here understand that saving the lost dolphins is the key to protecting their livelihoods, because without the dolphins, few tourists would venture to this isolated corner of the country. The second part of the overall strategy aimed at saving the dolphins is to provide local people with an alternative food source to fishing. With fishing rates reduced, there is less chance that the dolphins will be accidentally ensnared in nets, and they have a better chance of prospering if their food supplies are not depleted.
If we provide them more alternative livelihood on the land, for example, like the vegetable growing, chicken raising activity, pig raising activity, or improving their agriculture technique so that they can have enough food on the land, it can help to reduce the fishing pressure into the Mekong.
As well as helping to improve agricultural techniques, the CRDT has organized a voluntourism scheme in the area. Tourists pay about $80 for a three-day stay in a local village, most of which goes directly into the pockets of local people. While staying in the villages, the voluntourists work on development projects such as digging toilets, fishing, farming, or planting rice to help alleviate the villagers' over-reliance on fishing. In return for earning an income from the scheme, the villagers work to conserve the Irrawaddy dolphin's natural habitat. Roti Rong is the CRDT's local representative in Koh Phadao village. So far, efforts to save the Irrawaddy dolphin have had some success, and their numbers have remained steady at about 80 or so for the last decade. However, those numbers are so small that they remain critically endangered with a very uncertain future.